with the Glams on GMD.
Hey, shut up, you've had your say.
What do you think?
I mean, she wasn't eating enough, and she was just wasting
away. She had anorexia, and why?
She died.
Great. Folks, remember, 9 out of 10 people who don't eat enough end up very thin and very good. Yum, yum. That's all the time we have.
J'étais obsédé par la beauté de Nathalie. Et paranoïa quand j'aurais pu la perdre.
To get involved.
Crab sticks are the saveloy of the underwater world.
Ooh, look at those beautiful girls.
Well, it's day 3 of the Winsome Siege. Chat show host Ophel Winsome is still being held hostage against her will by vampire Count Alucard in this castle right behind me. I'm Dick Benedict, and we'll be talking live to Count Alucard on Primetime News right after this.
Para que se oiga cada día más, mucho más, el gran metal de Tepti, Betis Matas, para que todos estemos saltando de nuestros sitios al ritmo de la música.
Detectives, your mission is to save this planet's ecology with your top hit records. That's all for now.
I don't want to alarm you, but apparently there are gangs of witches operating in the forest area. And the police have advised us to stay clear.
That's the one I want, Steve! I've watched him, Steve!
So, how can I help you?
Marinate yourself!
Somewhere in this forest. Uncharted area. We haven't got any maps.
Yeah, and supposing we do go deep into the heart of the forest, how are we going to find our way back out again?
Has it, Mark?
Switch the contingency power.
Why have we stopped, Mark?
A tree's blocked the road up ahead. We'll have to turn back and try another route.
Look at the monitor. Something's growing over the path.
Right. Phil, Sarah, you get outside and try and hack us a path so we can find another route.
Are you the prince? Do you think that if you kissed me, maybe something magical would happen and then I'd be free?
I'll try.
Okay. Oh.
Mummy's home!
Oh, no.
Hello, sweetie. Want a bit of lardy cake?
I've just had breakfast.
Oh. Go on, stick something fleshy out so I can have a good feel.
You want to see someone, you do? All this plumping up like... You know, it's not natural. I don't know why you don't eat yourself, you fat fucking slag.
Shut your fairy trap!
Sarah? Phil, how are you getting on out there?
Well, we've hacked out a bit, but I've got bad news. The breadcrumbs have gone.
Well, at least we still have contingency power.
Cinders, if I still had my cherries, I'd...
Get the key.
That's a good idea.
Quick!
Going somewhere nice?
It's dinner time!
And Baby Bear said, someone's been sleeping in my bed. And she's still here. Suddenly... Goldilocks opened her eyes. She looked up, saw the three bears.
They shouted, she screamed. She leapt up and ran out of the house, over the fence, and all the way home. Once she got there, she had time to reflect. Sorry for what she'd done. They all lived happily ever after.
Well.
That's a great story, Mum. Where did you hear that?
I wish that we had some simple solution like that, you know?
How'd you do? I'm a great big fairy. I know I look a little unorthodox, but any trouble in these parts and folks come to me.
Pleased to meet you, great big fairy. We're a touring rock and roll band, and our lead, well, technically rhythm guitarist, has been kidnapped by a gang of witches. And we're afraid they may try to fatten him up and eat him.
Right. Well, that'll be Pearl Pot. She's tricky. We believe she lives on the south side of the forest. What we need is a sighting. We'll have to sit it out and wait for the sparrows.
A big blue wobbly thing beneath the sky.
Sort of like a road for ships, really.
The sea.
Yeah, buy this box of Astra from me, $12.95 to make you jive.
I've been holding out so long. I've been sleeping on my upstairs. You do the vegetables around the garnish and do all that lard. And I'll sit in the microwave.
I tell you what, love. I'm beginning to think maybe we should have deboned him. I'll tell you what, though, mate. You won't even touch the bloody sides.
Now, let's see. 10p a pound, that's... What is he, Cinders? Fat boy.
Ooh, can I have his cherries as an hors d'oeuvre?
All right, pet.
Hey, looks like I'm not going to make the gig.
We got 20 yards of open ground between the undergrowth and the house. Once inside, where's the oven? Uh-huh. And we got 14 seconds before that microwave goes ping. And the walls are made of milk chocolate, and the windows are reinforced glacier mint. We're gonna need to make some diversions. Thanks, Mr. Sparrow. Oh, and give my love to the wife and kids. I owe you one, yeah? Catch you later. Right, gentlemen. And ladies. You two are woodcutters. Anyone ask what you're doing, you're cutting wood. I'm going to smash my way through the glassy mint front door with this and turn the old egg into a frog. You, put the frighteners on the cat. And you, lover boy, you kiss the girl and you eat your way through the back the best way you can. Okay? Let's do it!
Oh, you're not brown enough. Try sizzle.
Oh no, it's a bloody great fairy! I know my rights. I'll be back on the streets in three.
Yeah, shut it, kiddie kids. Hey, handsome prince.
I'm right behind you, great big fairy.
Well, kiss the girl, then.
Right away, sir.
Oh, George. Thank goodness you're safe.
Thanks to you, Cinders.
Hello, beautiful. Here, George. I think this is a job for you. Kiss her again, George.
Hi, Dick Benedict with an update on the Winsome Siege. Well, all roads have been sealed off in the area and SWAT teams have been arriving all day long. Lieutenant, is there any chance that any of those wooden stakes are going to be used against Count Alucard?
Sooner or later, the talking's going to stop. That's when me and my boys are going to go in.
Well, it would seem that any means necessary are going to be used to free billionaire chat show hostess Ophel Winsome.
C'était le premier été de Ginny à Bordeaux. Et elle était anxieuse de s'intégrer avec tout le monde.
Which means that John has exactly 6 seconds to remove these chains. Are you ready, John?
Ready, Bart?
Five, four.
gonna look like the 4th of July.
Oh, yeah. Finn, I had a muffer drip again. Then I was bruck with no mini. Love, Leary.
Has anybody lost a gold Rolex watch?
What colour is it?
Solid gold with a diamond.
No, it's not mine.
For all those people remaining, please leave the theatre by the side door, please.
It smells like a barbecue. You in charge here? What happened? Yeah, there was something wrong with them shots. Yeah, who lit the fire?
Who did? Please leave the theatre. Thank you. Would you all please leave the theatre? There's nothing to see. Please leave the...
The girl who played Cinders. Get her in.
Still to come, Betty's Mad Dash. Happy Hour and Colin Corleone.
Hello and welcome back to Bare Knuckle Fighting. We've got some great action lined up for you tonight.
Anyway, his dog came out and shat in his garden. He picked it up and put it on his doorstep. His wife came out and kicked the dog, and then the other wife came out and she had to get involved. Would you believe it? It's all gone up between the wives, would you believe it? It's a double bill. They got involved, Jeff. Oh, well, dog shite or no dog shite, you can be sure they're going to have to build a bigger wall.
And to me, that was formless. It was ad hoc.
Messy.
Absolutely messy, for want of a better word, Del. You and I both know.
We've seen this before.
We have. We've seen this time and again. I don't want to see it again, really.
Boondoggy had one dream, to be the first man to surf the Pacific Ocean. But his friends just want a party. Only one girl could understand.
What's the matter, Boondoggy? Aren't you coming to the luau?
I need to eat some foam, Piglet.
Ted Gazur, Sharon McCloy.
You mean you're gonna watusi on the mountain?
Uh-huh.
And jiggle the jello?
Boondoggy Beach.
Oh, Boondoggy, you send me. You're my conch king.
Boondoggy Beach, straight to video. Rent it now.
If you have any complaints about the Ragamuffin sketches, please don't complain to the BBC. Come and see me.
That is Mad Dash. Lydia and Maisie have returned safely to the right side of the channel, but they're back on the wrong side of the law again.
Shorts up, Chunky!
Oh, who are you?
I'm Betty and this is Maisie. Do as you're told and you won't get hurt.
You've come a bit early. I'm afraid you've caught me rather déshabillé.
All right, that's enough flim-flam. Cut along, Duke.
And remember, if you don't behave yourself, you'll get a bullet in the head.
Thank you, Roberts. So, you say you want protection from the police?
We'll have to lay low for a while. Then we'll need a bed for the night and a change of clothes, if that's all right.
Of course. And, how long do you intend to stay?
Well, until the hunt dies down anyway. Will you smoke?
Yes, I will. And am I allowed to know what this is all about?
Afraid not. It's highly secret.
How exciting. I was wondering whether you two attractive young ladies would care to join me
in a bath.
Yes, we will.
There really is no hurry, you know. You can stay here as long as you like.
Well, it is return Monday, my lord.
At least until Monday, then, eh?
Morning.
I say. Fancy me the tap end, eh?
Daddy, sir, what on earth's going on?
Hello, Chunky.
Gerald, I was just arranging the entertainment for your stag night.
Oh.
Step on it, Sergeant.
Hold on, sir.
Second chance to see part 23 of our 36-part series, The Tree, a chilling tale of intrigue and espionage.
Want to do it? Just want to watch? Well, watch this! Nikki's Special Party Pack. 0898-6969-69. Getting too much for you? Getting embarrassed?
Stop. Please stop.
No problem. Stop the show whenever you like. Call Nikki.
It's hard to imagine that this magnificent monument behind me is going to be demolished and replaced by an exact replica.
L'amour qui court au déjeuner. Le dernier film de Jean-Jacques Moret. L'amour qui court au déjeuner. Le dernier film de Jean-Jacques Moret.
Johnny's been dead for years and no one seems to have noticed.
Johnny, you're such a layabout.
And now it's time to go to Pussy's with Len and Ted.
It's happy hour!
Tonight's episode, Vera and the Fire Officer.
Here, Len. I'm getting really worried about that Vera's fire eating act, you know. It burnt a hole in the polished iron tiles. Well, it weren't so much burnt as like oozing out. As it happened, it smelt a bit toxic.
Yeah. Speaking of Vera, yeah. I took her out last night. It don't talk much, does it? Anyway, went back to her place, had a bit of a drink, bit of a smoke, bit of a dance. She loved it.
She, Len?
She loved it.
She?
Looks like rain.
Since the dawn of time, nothing is as bright or as fast as this. The sun. It lights up your day the sun. Don't be left in the dark.
Why not buy this 17th floor flat? Great view. Plenty of neighbours. Walking distance from Heathrow and the M4. Take possession today. Move in now.
I've been thinking, Mr. Ted.
Oh, yeah?
Maybe we should get some seats down there and some music.
Yeah, maybe we should get some fire exits.
Oh, come on, Mr. Ted, how often do we have a fire?
Yeah, that's true. We're not a charity, are we?
Cost money.
Yeah. Supposing we did have a fire down there, I mean, how the punters going to get out?
Same way they got in. Great deal of luck.
Yeah. Your name's not Dan, so you're not coming in.
I'm Chief Officer Stanley, and I've come to check your fire exits and gangways.
There's no fire here, mate.
Yeah, why aren't you out fighting fires?
My job is to prevent fires.
Oh, yeah? So what, they paying you to predict where fires are going to happen now, are they?
Look, I'm a senior fire officer.
Yeah, we know that. Tell us something we don't know.
And if you don't cooperate, I'll have no option but to issue you with a court order and have your licence revoked.
Is that right? Well, let me tell you something. We haven't got a licence to revoke. So stick that in your ass pipe, you puffed up, Jesse.
You'll be hearing from us.
Oh, yeah? Sling her up. And I'll tell you something else, mate. Call yourself a bleeding fireman? More like a pain in the arse, man. If I catch you round here predicting fires, I'll rip your bleeding throat out. What?
Fire!
Hey, I'm smoking, Mr. Ted.
No fire!
If you want to learn to dance like this, come to Sammy's Personality Jazz Dancing every Wednesday and Saturday at the Forum, City Road, York.
Some of them really are quite big. Well, if you're going to swim to America here across the Atlantic, you're going to have to do a lot of swimming. Well, there's the water. Here are my arms. Off I go.
Hi, welcome back. I'm Dick Benedict, and we have an exclusive live phone link-up with Count Alucard in the besieged castle. Count, can you hear me?
Yes, I can, Bob. May I first of all say that nobody here is being held against their will?
Hey, if that's true what you're saying, why can't we see her?
Why don't you put your close-up cameras at the tower window to your
can
left?
Can somebody get this? Are we in position? Charlie, camera two, can camera two get... We're about to bring you exclusive pictures of Ophel Winsome, chat show hostess, being held hostage by Count Alucard. Have we got that? Are we on the air?
Okay, what's your message?
Yes, 10-4, we have a jungle south of Africa.
And now, the life and times of Colin Corleone.
In the name of Holy Jesus, I present myself as godfather of this baby. I renounce Satan and all other mooks who may stand in the path of righteousness. And I rename this child Michael Santino Fredo Corleone.
Colin Potter, I've a summons to court for you from Star Video Rentals.
Thank you. Right, next case. Call Colin Potter. Colin Potter, you are charged with default of payment to Rumbelow's Star Video for the hire of Godfather Parts 1 and 2 for the period of 46 weeks, amounting to the cost of £112. How do you plead?
Not guilty. He says not guilty, Your Honour.
Would you kindly ask your friend to remove the coat from his head?
Yeah. Yeah, sure, sure.
Your Honour, he says he wants you to remove all the mooks with the camwish from the balcony.
But we don't have a gallery.
I ain't going to have a gallery, boys.
Ain't got one, Cole.
No, it's not gallery.
Hmm. Firstly, I would like to say that I'm not a murderer.
But no one said that you were.
I'm a simple olive oil importer from a small peasant family in Sicily. May I approach the bench, Your Honour?
If you must.
Mr. Birchall, you're a very understanding man. And you have such a beautiful wife and lovely family. I'm sure you would not want them to be endangered.
But they are not, Mr. Potter. Now, if we could get on with this, please, I would like to hurry up so I can go home and have some tea.
I want to play bargain, Your Honour. I'm a man of the community, and I'm sure you would not want to deprive the people of my protection and guidance. So, in my defense, I would like to call a few witnesses to the bench.
Mr. Potter, this is a small claims court. We don't need to hear from witnesses.
Firstly, I call my dear mama. Mama?
Your Honor, I ask you to show mercy on my son. He is not in a proper state of mind. These videos that he watches have changed him completely. I beg of you to put him in a secure place, an hospital where they can help him with his problem.
Yes, I feel for you, Mrs. Potter, and I quite understand that that would be for the best, but as I tried to explain to you before, this is a small claims court. We cannot hospitalise anybody. We don't have the power to put anybody anywhere. All we want him to do is to pay the fine.
I call my sister Mary.
Mum's right. Colin is sick. He desperately needs help. He ruined my wedding day through his selfishness. He came to my house to try to ruin my marriage. He's just tried to kill the godfather of my child. And if anything ever happened to me, I would never want my mad brother anywhere near my son. And to top it all, he tried to kill my mother.
He didn't! Order.
She only went in for an ingrown toenail after he finished with her. She ends up with a broken arm and a leg.
We want to confess everything. We wasn't part of this network of crime and corruption. It was him,
Order.
Your Honour!
Order!
You want to watch it?
Order!
Tomorrow night, part 8 of the award-winning Scandal in a Diving Bell. Scandal in a Diving Bell, tomorrow night.
And now, the last time, with their special guests, the Glam Metal Detectives!
Everybody up! Everybody down! Everybody up! Everybody down!
I said boom! And justice! I said boom! And justice!
Kill me about the fact that
good gig.
What's that, Commander? We're number one on Mars. Well, that's good, because, well, who knows?
Oh!